Apollo is the Olympian god of the sun, music, poetry, healing, archery, order and beauty, and agriculture. He is one of the 12 Olympian gods, who live on Mount Olympus. Artemis, the Greek goddess of hunting, is his twin sister. Apollo was arguably the most loved of all the Greek gods. He was particularly worshipped at Delphi and Delos, amongst the most famous of all religious sanctuaries in the Greek world. Leto was the daughter of Titans Croesus and Phoebe. She had some supernatural powers herself, but only a few, compared to the Olympian gods. Leto is mostly famous because of her relationship with Zeus, which resulted in giving birth to two divine children, Artemis and Apollo. She was very gracious and lovable deity, but was hated by Hera, the wife of Zeus, for having seduced her husband. Leto was pregnant, furious and ashamed of this betrayal from Zeus. Hera cursed Leto not to find a solid ground or island on earth to give birth to her children. She even held her daughter Eileithyia, the goddess of childbirth, firmly in her arms, to prevent her from supporting Leto on her labor. Leto, in labor and great pain, had wandered around all Greece to find a place to give birth, but people didn't let her bear her children close to their homes, afraid of Hera's anger. That is when Zeus emerged an island from the sea, so that Leto would find a refugee. This island was Delos, which was believed to be a floating island. For 9 days, and 9 nights, Leto was suffering from strong pains, until in the 10th day, Leto went close to small lake and gave birth to Artemis, the Greek goddess of the hunt. Artemis then acted as a midwife to her mother, to bring her brother Apollo to the world. For this reason, she was declared as the new goddess of the childbirth, taking the place of Hera's daughter, Eileithyia. Due to Leto's inability to feed the newborn, Themis, the goddess of divine law, fed him an immortality drink called ambrosia. At the first taste of ambrosia, Apollo immediately transformed into a man. Moreover, Apollo came to be regarded as the most beautiful Greek god. When Apollo was just 4 days old, he would leave his mother's side and make his way to the workshop of the metal-working god, Hephaestus. In order to avenge the trouble given to his mother while she was pregnant, the young Apollo wanted to kill the python. A silver bow with golden arrows, given to him by the blacksmith, Hephaestus, made the young god decide to kill Python and take revenge. Python was traditionally the child of Gaia, the personification of Earth. Initially known to be a female python, and was represented as medieval-style dragon. According to Greek mythology, Delphi was the center of the Earth, and thus, Python was the guardian of the Delphi. When Hera discovered that Leto was pregnant with child of Zeus, she sent Python to kill Leto. Soon Apollo went to the creature's cave to seek after the python. When the creature faced Apollo, it started boiling with the rage and lunged at Apollo to devour him. The python was not an easy opponent for Apollo to overcome, but by shooting off 100 arrows, eventually the python was killed. The corpse of the python was left outside of the main Delphic temple, and so the temple and oracle were sometimes referred to as the Pytho. Apollo was so enraged that he dared to violate the sanctity of the site by staining it with Python's blood. Zeus ordered Apollo to cleanse himself, after which he returned to Delphi and claimed the shrine to his name. Hermes was known to be a cunning trickster, stealing things from the other gods and hiding them in unbelievable locations. Back in the days, when Hermes was still an infant, he once went out his cradle and stared an adventure to Pyrrha. He stole the cattle from his half-brother Apollo. Apollo soon found out that his herd was missing and started searching all around. He found out that the thief and went furiously to Mount Selene to find Hermes in his cave. Little Hermes was peacefully sleeping inside his cradle. Apollo grabbed the infant and took him up to Mount Olympus to be judged by their father Zeus. Regretful of what he had done, Hermes then offered Apollo his ear as a present. The ear was a musical instrument Hermes had created all by himself out of the shell of tortoise. Apollo, the eternally beautiful youth, rarely seems to have been happy in his love. Either his advances met with a repulse, or his union met to fatal consequences. Daphne was a naiad nymph in Greek mythology, and was the daughter of a river god. She was famous for being incredibly beautiful, and for catching the eye of Apollo. However, Daphne was determined to remain unmarried, and untouched by a man by the rest of her life. Greek mythology states that Apollo had been mocking the god of love, Eros, also known as Cupid. In retaliation, Eros fired two arrows, a gold arrow that struck Apollo, and made him fall in love with Daphne, and a lead arrow that made Daphne hate Apollo. Under the spell of the arrow, Apollo continued to follow Daphne, but she continued to reject him. Apollo told Daphne that he would love her forever. Daphne turned to the river god, Peneus, and pleaded for him to free her from Apollo. In response, Peneus used metamorphosis to turn Daphne into a laurel tree. It's believed that Daphne has to sacrifice her body and turn into a tree, as this was the only way she could avoid Apollo's sexual advances. Apollo was also famous for being an oracular god, and had two cults in Delphi and Delos. People would come from all over the world to learn from Apollo what their future held. It was believed that, as the god of both medicine and plague, Apollo could heal people, as well as cause disease by shooting people with his arrows.